In this video from our .NET MAUI tutorial series, I'll guide you through implementing authentication and authorization in a .NET MAUI application. We'll integrate authentication by consuming a web API and receiving a JWT token. For role-based access, administrators will have full control to view, add, edit, and delete user accounts, while regular users will be limited to viewing user accounts only. Let's dive into how to implement this step by step. In our current .NET MAUI app, we have options to add new users and view the existing ones. Now, we need to implement a login page, and here we'll display the logged in user. Note that the logout functionality is yet to be implemented. Only users with the administrator role will be allowed to add, edit, and delete accounts. We've also added a pop-up feature for editing or deleting users when clicking on a list item. Let's go ahead and add a new user by providing the required details. The user has been successfully added, and we can see the new entry in the database. We're hashing the password before saving it to the database. Now, let's try editing this user and updating the details. The user has been updated successfully, and the changes are reflected in the database. Finally, I'll delete the user. The user has been removed from the list, and the deletion is also confirmed in the database. We already have the API project set up in our solution. In the account controller, we have a login method that accepts the username and password, returning a JWT token along with the authenticated user and their role. For a detailed guide on implementing JWT authentication in an ASP.NET Core Web API, you can check out this video on our channel. The link is available in the description. In the User Account Controller, we've already implemented methods for create, read, update, and delete operations. We'll now add the authorize attribute to the read methods, allowing access to any authenticated users. For the create, update, and delete methods, we'll apply the authorize attribute with role-based restrictions, ensuring only administrator users can perform these actions. Now, let's implement authentication in our .NET MAUI app. Before we proceed, I want to remind you that the source code for this project is available in our Patreon community. First, we'll create a service called authentication service. In the constructor of this class, we'll inject HTTP client factory as a dependency service. I'll then declare a private read-only HTTP client object and assign it by creating a client using the HTTP client factory. Next, we'll create a new model class called user session. This class will have three properties: username, access token, and role. We can now declare user session as a private variable within our authentication service. Moving forward, we'll implement the method for authentication, which will return a Boolean value based on the authentication status. The method will call the API by passing the username and password. If the response is successful, we'll assign the user session object by reading it from the response body. Once the session data is successfully read, we'll save it in JSON format inside the secure storage using a key called user account session. This will allow us to retrieve it later if the user closes and reopens the app. Finally, the method will return true to indicate successful authentication. Now, let's create a method to retrieve the user session from secure storage. First, we'll read the JSON formatted user session from secure storage. If the JSON string is not null, we'll deserialize it and assign it to the user session object. Next, we'll implement a method for logging out the user. The first step is to remove the user session from secure storage. After that, we'll set the user session object to null. We'll also add a public method to access the user session object from the view modals. Additionally, I'll include a public property isAdmin, which will return true if the user has the administrator role. Finally, we'll register the authentication service as a dependency service. Next, we'll implement the login page. First, let's create the view model. We'll inherit this class from ObserverObject which is part of the community toolkit.mvvm. In the constructor, we'll inject the newly created authentication service and assign it to a private read-only field. In the login view model, we'll need two properties, username and password. Now, let's create a method for the login button. Initially, we'll display an error message if the username or password is empty. Next, we'll call the authenticate method from the authentication service that we created earlier. If the user is successfully authenticated, we'll navigate them to the main page. If authentication fails, we'll show the same error message. Moving on, we'll create the content page for login. I've provided a simple layout with entry fields for username and password along with a login button. In the page class, we'll set the binding context to login page view model. Finally, in the MAUI program class, I'll register the login page as a dependency. Next, let's update the main page view model. First, we'll inject the authentication service dependency just as we did before. Now, we'll create a method to check the authentication state when loading the main page. This method will use the fetch user account session from the authentication service. If the user account session is null, we'll navigate the user to the login page. Otherwise, we'll clear any existing authorization header and assign the JWT token to the HTTP client authorization header. We'll then create an observable property named isAdministrator, assigning its value based on the isAdmin property from the authentication service. Additionally, we'll create another observable property to store the authenticated username so it can be displayed on the page. The value will be assigned from the user account session. Next, we'll load the list of users here. In the previous initialize method, we'll replace the user list loading with a call to this new method. Now, let's implement the logout button click command. This will simply call the logout method from the authentication service and navigate the user back to the login page. We also have a method that is triggered when a user taps on a list item. We'll show edit and delete options only for administrator users, as regular users can only view the records. Lastly, on the main page, we have the option to add users. We'll make this entire grid visible only if the user is an administrator. In the app shell, let's add the shell content for the login page. When we run the application, you'll see that we are now navigated to the login page. Let's try logging in with an admin user. Oh, I forgot to bind the current username. We can bind it to this label in the main page. Now, the username is displayed correctly. Let's go ahead and create a new user. The user has been successfully created. Now, let's try logging in with the new user. Since this user is not an administrator, the add option is hidden. Also, when tapping on a list item, the pop-up for editing or deleting is not shown. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. You can access all source codes and exclusive content by joining our Patreon community. Become part of a growing community to enhance your skills and enjoy exclusive benefits. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.